Hello friends, how are you today? Hope you've witnessed history being created with Crew 1 launch, and also watched our last episode on this. Now, let's discuss some latest updates. As usual, let's start with SpaceX. SpaceX's November 21st Starlink 15 launch is expected to use the Falcon 9 B1049 booster, which will become the first rocket booster to launch for the seventh time. Starlink 15 will effectively mean that SpaceX is 70% on the way towards achieving its long-standing goal of 10 launches per booster. SpaceX is attempting for two separate Falcon 9 launches and landings within the 10 hours. It will mark the company's 14th Starlink mission in 2020 and first launch from the West Coast. SpaceX has successfully completed Crew Dragon's operational astronaut launch debut on the East Coast, relieving the company to shift focus on its third mission on November, Starlink V1 L15. Starlink 15 is currently scheduled to lift off at 10:17 p.m. Eastern Time on the 21st of November, surprisingly, just within 10 hours of Falcon 9's Sentinel 6A launch. After solving the minor issues, two Falcon 9 booster engines were replaced, which effectively reactivated a dormant orbital launch complex. SpaceX is officially set to launch the Sentinel 6A oceanography satellite at 9:17 a.m. Pacific Standard Time on Saturday, the 21st of November. The most remarkable feature is that Falcon 9 will be launched for the first time from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. SpaceX's Sentinel 6A launch will use the new Falcon 9 booster B1063 for the first time. It was first seen on the way from the company's McGregor, Texas test facilities to Vandenberg Air Force Base in late August. SpaceX replaced, on an average, two Merlin 1D engines of the three boosters in a course that took months. One more problem came in the forefront that all three new boosters were assigned to high-profile missions for NASA and U.S. military customers. SpaceX managed to complete the entire complex rocket engine anomaly investigation in less than 6 weeks. They fished out the root cause and then replicated the failure mode with individual engine static fires. Finally, they replaced multiple engines on three boosters and then rechecked all three boosters for their respective flight launches. Out of three boosters, only B1063 is the novice one. All three will likely support many launches in the coming days. Let's move on to our next news for today. Ariane Space Vega rocket failed to deliver the satellites for Spain and France because of a major launch failure. Vega rocket is a four-stage launch vehicle jointly developed by the Italian Space Agency and the European Space Agency. The rocket is around 100 feet, 30 meters tall, featuring three solid-fueled stages topped by a liquid-fueled fourth stage called the Attitude and Vernier Upper Module, or AVUM. On Monday, November 16th, Vega rocket lifted off from the Guiana Space Center in Curau, French Guiana at 8:52 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The rocket was carrying two satellites. First, an Earth-watching satellite for Spain called CEOSAT Ingenio. It is Spain's first Earth observation satellite used by a European Space Agency program to study this planet. The satellite has a high-resolution dual camera with a mechanism to look sideways and down to observe any point on Earth over 3 days. It can image Earth with a resolution of 2.5 meters or 8.2 feet. The next one is a science satellite, Tyrannus, for France's space agency CNES. This satellite is designed to observe extremely bright electrical phenomena in Earth's upper atmosphere. CNES officials are expecting to study brilliant visible light flashes known as sprites, blue jets, and elves, as well as gamma-ray flashes, with this satellite for at least 4 years. At first, the rocket was flying smoothly, according to the plan, but after a few minutes, something went wrong, which led this mission to failure. "We can now confirm that the mission is lost," Ariane Space CEO Stephanie Israel reported during the launch webcast. According to Ariane Space, the problem started 8 minutes after the liftoff when Vega rocket ignited its upper stage, AVUM. After the ignition, it went off course on a degraded trajectory and never made any contact with ground stations. As a result, the Vega rocket, along with the two satellites, completely lost. Shortly after the failure, Ariane Space stated on Twitter, "Trajectory degraded on VV-17 after first initiation of the AVIM engine. Investigations on the anomaly ongoing. More to come shortly." Currently, Ariane Space engineers are checking every data to track down the cause of this mission failure. 8 minutes after liftoff of Vega mission VV-17, following the first ignition of the engine of the AVIM upper stage, a deviation of trajectory was identified, entailing the loss of the mission, the company stated. Telemetry data analyses are in progress to determine the cause of this failure. Monday's launch failure marked the second major malfunction of the Vega rocket in 2 years. In July 2019, a Vega rocket was scheduled to carry a satellite for the United Arab Emirates. Engineers did an investigation and later found the rocket failed to launch due to a faulty motor on the booster. On September 2nd, the Vega rocket made a comeback after its failure and successfully launched 53 small satellites for 21 different customers. The same cannot be said for Vega's follow-up mission. "I want to present my deepest apologies to my customers for this mission," Israel stated. "Ariane Space is presenting its apologies, and we have now to analyze and to understand. The investigation is ongoing." Ariane Space Vega rockets are capable of carrying 3,300 pounds, or about 1,500 kilograms, of cargo to polar orbits, which is over 400 miles or 700 kilometers above Earth. The Vega rocket has 2 launch failures out of 17 times since it first made its debut in 2012. According to recent information, a modified version of Vega rocket, also known as Vega C, is being developed by Ariane Space and the European Space Agency. Vega C is expected to carry 5,070 pounds or 2,300 kilograms payloads, which is 60% more than the current Vega rocket. Meanwhile, Ariane Space is also planning to launch its next Vega rocket, VV-18, in early 2021. The next Vega rocket will carry the Pleiades Neo-1 imaging satellite as primary payload, along with a batch of SmallSat. In our last segment, let's now look at a news related to NASA. NASA recently stated bringing Mars samples to Earth could cost an extra $1 billion. Jeffrey Gramling, NASA's Mars Sample Return Program Director, said during a news conference held on the 10th of November, "Every mission to Mars has things that we're worried about." In the same conference, Peter Thysinger, a member of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in California, said, "The conditions when you arrive at Mars change dramatically over the Martian year." Thomas Zurbuchen, NASA's Associate Administrator for Science, said, "Basically, the way we're interpreting the collective set of recommendations is full steam ahead. The last thing that we want to do is kind of turn a switch right now, without really investigating this and looking at all the options. The only reason we did it is to enhance our opportunities to be successful by opening our eyes wide. I want us to really challenge ourselves for missions, but we want to do so every time by keeping our eyes open and learning from every opportunity we have." NASA created the Independent Review Board in August to calculate plans for the Mars sample return missions and to detect potential threats at a rapid phase. David Thompson, chairman of the Independent Review Board and former president of commercial space company Orbital ATK, said in the conference, "We unanimously believe that the Mars sample return program should proceed. We think its scientific value will be extraordinarily high, with the potential for world-changing discoveries about Earth's nearest planetary neighbors, and possibly about an independent origin of life on another world. However, as the first round-trip mission to another planet, Mars sample return is also an extremely ambitious, technically demanding, and operationally complex program. The board is confident to break through all the hurdles to fetch Martian rocks to Earth." Maria Zuber, another member of the review board and a planetary scientist at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, said during the news conference, "The science would be very exciting. We've done a lot of analysis in situ with Mars rocks on the surface of Mars, and clearly those have been very valuable. But what you can do with a rock, bringing it back and working in a terrestrial lab. She also said, the samples will produce a timeline essentially of the history of what was going on in this crater. The board also suggested changes in management to the Mars 2020 mission. The sample-fetching rover, to take samples of Martian soil, is building on the European and Russian ExoMars rover scheduled to launch in the year 2022. It would also benefit from additional mobility improvements. At present, all planned surface missions are designed to be solar-powered. If nuclear power is added, then it would make the mission safe and reliable. The board found that the next spacecraft in the mission would be able to launch in 2026. NASA and the European Space Agency presently are hoping that 2028 will be the next launch year if they could not place a launch in 2026. NASA plans to continue targeting the earlier launch date and delay down the timeline as necessary. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.